Nós moramos em Bali, na Indonésia, a capital dos nômades digitais no mundo. E aqui a gente teve a oportunidade de conhecer diversos outros criadores mundiais, mesmo produzindo conteúdo em português. O vídeo de hoje vai ser em inglês e a gente vai compartilhar uma conversa que a gente teve com o nosso grande amigo Nicholas Krish, um grande criador de conteúdo.
Sejam bem-vindos a mais um vlog. Igual vocês viram no título, na capa desse vídeo, a gente vai conversar com uma pessoa muito especial.
A gente fez uma caixinha de perguntas lá no nosso Instagram e a gente separou as melhores para fazer para ele.
Welcome
to the Casal Hack Channel.
Thank you.
You are so famous in Brazil.
Am I?
Everybody love you.
Yeah?
Yeah, a lot.
Yeah, I still can't quite believe it, to be honest, because I don't see many Portuguese comments in my videos, but...
Now you know, guys.
Gente, vai lá comentar no canal do Vera.
Comenta em português, porque ele falou que não tem tanto comentário em português. All right, bro, welcome. First thing first, we will open one box on Instagram, like, with a lot of questions. We, like, select, like, the best questions for you.
All right.
There is, like, a random question, but it's a really good question. Why did you decide to recording videos in English and not on your, like, native language?
Yeah, so basically I'm from Germany originally.
You can.
I can go in the middle, oh wow, yeah. Hey. So I'm originally from Germany, but I always felt a lot more drawn to the English language because I traveled for 1 year after graduating from high school. And I just loved to like connect with people from other countries. And when coming back to Germany, I just felt like, yeah, like I would prefer to just like have my YouTube channel in English because I always wanted to move to a foreign country sometime down the road. And so yeah, basically I just decided, okay, I'm going to do my YouTube channel in English because then I can speak with creators like you and
that
I can make
really
videos.
Great.
I mean, there's a lot of different benefits to it, but like number one reason for me was I just felt more comfortable in English and I wanted to make videos with creators from like other countries as well, but obviously there's also a much larger audience when it comes to the videos you create, and I think that really also like played into it for me because yeah, I think there wouldn't be as many subscribers and viewers if I would make my videos in German.
Definitely.
And I just love the idea that everybody can understand what we're talking about.
Yeah.
I hope you can understand.
If you're recording our videos on German, it's impossible for us to find you.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah.
There is an interesting question. There is from Fernando...
Fernando Urias.
Urias. That's it. I think that's it. He made the question. How many people was like necessary to make your most popular video on your channel?
How many people were necessary to produce it?
To make the video.
One person.
Just
it
him.
It was just me.
Yeah, the people can't believe that.
Oh, really?
Sometimes they think like, oh, he has like a copywriter.
Oh, yeah.
He has like one people to do the script.
No, I basically do everything myself. I script my videos myself, film myself, edit myself. And I don't know, if you become quite good at placing a tripod, then you can film anything by yourself. And my most viewed video is the dopamine detox video. Now it has like more than 10 million, which is insane.
10 million!
And yeah, that video was just filmed by myself. Sometimes I film together with friends when it comes to like, if I want to shoot some like stage scenes and I'm telling like a specific story where I want to have more of a like, yeah, short film look, I guess. And then I'm just like, asking friends who are also filmmakers to help me film. But besides that, the majority of my videos is just filmed by myself.
And how many days to edit that video?
Yeah, there is like the first question I do for him was like that. Like, bro,
which video? The dopamine detox.
Dopamine detox.
Okay, take a guess.
7 days, 1 week?
Yeah.
1 week?
Yeah, seven
like,
days.
Working every day on this video?
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
How many hours per day, like? Do you know?
8-9 hours.
What? Wow.
But it's so interesting, like, when I talk with different creators, some people are like, oh wow, that's so fast, like I can't believe it. And some others are like, oh wow, that's so long. So I think it's like, it's different for every person, but like,
yeah, definitely.
I obviously put a lot of emphasis on like sound design, on like color grading and all that stuff. So I just want the videos to be very polished and that's why I put in the extra effort. But like in general, like the average video would probably take me somewhere between 4 to 5 days, I guess.
4 to 5 days.
Yeah, yeah.
It's 'cause I never spend like more than 1 day on the video.
Yeah, never.
It's like 8 hours, 10 hours maximum.
Yeah, yeah. No, it's different there, I guess.
Yeah, but you can saw like it's completely different. Have ever you imagined like with the video dopamine become to be like so viral?
No.
Like how it come to be?
No, definitely not. Like it's actually funny when I was shooting that video, like it was filmed at my dad's place. My dad is living in Mallorca in Spain. And it was funny, I was there, my brother was also there, and my dad and my brother actually made a little bit of fun about me when I was shooting that video. They were like, dopamine detox, what the hell is this? Just like some weird trend. And yeah, I don't know. I just felt like it was an important message to share. So I just created that video. I edited the video and I had the feeling, yeah, it was very good. And I also knew that it has potential because around like, I think 5 to 6 months before, I already made a video where I did a social media detox for 30 days. So that video had like 2 million. So I was like, yeah, it can definitely go into like a similar like view count, but then it really exploded right from the start. And I don't know, it's very interesting to watch the video grow because it gets some pushes every now and then where it gets sometimes like 1 million views in a month. And then again, it just gets like 100,000 in a month. So it's very interesting to see how the YouTube algorithm just pushes the video sometimes. But it just never stopped pushing, you know, like it's still pushing now and it's still the video that makes me my most ad revenue every month, you know?
Yeah, incredible. That is incredible.
Storytelling of Nika, it's really like, it's fucking amazing. How did you take like this kind of insight to build this kind of script?
I feel like...
Did you like meditation with your headphones and back, oh, I have an incredible insight?
No, not really. To be honest, for me, it was like, I spent a lot of time just like filming very commercial-like videos, so making things look very good, shooting cinematic videos, putting a lot of emphasis on color grading, sound design, all that stuff. But at some point I reached a level where I felt like, okay, I'm quite good at it. Obviously I can still learn new things, but I need something more. I felt like there was something missing in my videos. And at that point I just started to write scripts. And as soon as I started to write scripts, I put a lot more emphasis on the stories I was telling. And then I just created one video after the other one. And I just found out a lot of different things about visual storytelling, how you can tell stories through video. And I don't know. I guess it's just repetition, to be honest. It's just repetition, looking at your scripts, at your videos. At some point, I also started writing shot lists, which also helps a lot when you, like, for example, shoot stage scenes. And yeah, to be honest, it's just a lot of intuitive learning. I was always a learner who's just like trying out things and just learning from my failures. And that's the same way I did it with storytelling. So it's just a lot of intuitive knowledge that I gathered over the last years. And it's sometimes hard to explain because there is not really like one specific place where you can learn storytelling like this. And that's the exact reason why I now dedicated much time. Yeah.
And a few months you have one place where you can like learn this kind of storytelling.
Exactly. So now I basically like dedicated months of my time to create exactly what I was looking for when I was starting out with filmmaking. I always wanted to do all of the different steps of the filmmaking process, but I never found anything because at film schools you either learn how to be a director, a cinematographer, an editor, a screenwriter. You can just be one of the parts, but I wanted to be all of it, you know?
Yeah.
And I feel like that's also the direction where everything goes nowadays. Every content creator creates, like, does all the parts of it. You shoot, you edit, you script, and
especially like for filmmaking.
Yeah.
Because if you're like a part of the crew, it's not like easy, but I need to be like the director.
Yeah, exactly.
Of this move. All right, it's okay. But when you're filmmaking, you need to be director, the camera, the editor.
It's a lot. It's a lot. And it takes some time to get used to it. But yeah, that's why I now basically just put all of my effort into crafting the perfect online course to really teach everything step by step so that literally like anybody can learn to get onto a similar level as I am. And yeah, I feel like this course is gonna be a good resource
insane.
To learn.
It'll be insane.
A good resource to learn storytelling, I guess, yeah.
Yeah, really good. One video I most like on your channel, of course, I love Dopamine and all of the other videos. But it's like, stop you waiting.
Stop waiting for life to happen.
Yeah, that was really good, bro. Yeah. It's because you tell right now, you don't like do nothing to learn that. You just like start your script, your videos, oh, find one way, I love this way, let's do again and repeat a lot of times.
Yeah, and I think that's a big learning for anything in life is to just get started and to just develop a mindset that you're just persistent. You just don't stop until you get what you want.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what I do in basically any part of my life. I mean, that video was about me moving to Cape Town. It's basically I left my home country, moved to a foreign country for the first time in my life. And I was also thinking before, like, there's so much stuff I need to take care of with visas and with an apartment and all that stuff. But as soon as you just like book your flight, you just make it happen, then everything just falls into place and you just learn by throwing yourself into the cold water. And that's how I do it with everything.
And you think like, oh, it was like so easy. And it was like so fast.
Exactly. Oh, wow. I mean, that was what I was saying in that video. And it's the same if you want to learn filmmaking, you know, like you can look for like years for the perfect film school, the perfect program, whatever you feel like. But you just have to get started and you just have to practice. There's no shortcut to that. Obviously, there is kind of like a fast track to learn specific things, but you have to put in the time in order to become really good and in order to stand out from other people. Yeah.
I have nothing to say anymore. How was the feeling to create your first video and become to be paid for this video? Become to be sponsored for this video?
I think in the beginning it was definitely like, when I was starting out, it was something very exciting. The first sponsored video, this is kind of like where you realize, oh wow, like I can maybe turn this into like a full-time career. So it was definitely a special moment to have my first sponsorship. But I also feel like over the last 2 years, I very much developed when it comes to my mindset. And now I'm a much bigger fan of creating my own products and creating really like the content which I want to create and not have any brands, I don't know, telling me what to do or what not to do.
Yeah, it's really hard.
So I still like working with like my top sponsors. I love them, but I think I went more into a direction where I'm trying to just create my own products that provide value to my community. Yeah.
And I think a lot of people who are on this channel right now, they have your product with them, your subtitles. Yeah. Your preset, your loot. Do you have any advice for the people who are start the career with filmmaking?
Okay, so honestly, obviously this is the same thing I said before, but the most important is that you just get started. If you want, if you are just merely excited in filmmaking, then just pick up a camera, get started and start to create videos, because it is a long journey until you get to a point where you actually say, okay, this is exactly the type of videos I want to create. And you just have to try out a lot of different niches in order to find out what you really like. So maybe you start out by shooting cars and then at some point you go to, I don't know, shooting weddings, and at some point you want to create YouTube videos. And I think it's just really important to get started, to try out a lot of different niches, and to just honestly never give up on that journey. If you decide for yourself that you want to become a filmmaker, you can 100% can make it happen. Now is the best time in human history to become a filmmaker. There's definitely so much demand for it. So I hope that this can somehow be a motivation, that there have been so many people telling me that I wouldn't be able to become a YouTuber or make money from filmmaking, and now I basically just proved the complete opposite, and I hope that this can be some sort of inspiration for you guys to also just say, hey, I don't have to work in a normal job, but if you want to be a filmmaker, then you can definitely be a filmmaker. Yeah.
Incredible.
Last,
it's because there is most popular question.
Yeah, this is a
tip for starting out. I mean, there are a lot of tips, but honestly, the most important one is that you just have a belief in yourself and that you just get started and that you just push through, because then everything is going to fall into place. You're going to meet other filmmakers, you're going to get better at your craft, and then everything is just going to come into play by itself.
You need to have this first step, and after...
Exactly.
It's a beautiful way to enjoy the journey with filmmaker career. It's really good. The last one, do you have some inspiration, someone who inspire you a lot? And what keep you to motivate to do what you want to do?
Okay, I feel like there's a little two questions: who inspires me and what motivates me to do what I do. Who inspires me? Oh yeah, you can still see me.
Who inspire you?
So when it comes to inspirations, I guess there's a couple of creators that I look up to, but just in different fields. So one creator I really like is Nathaniel Drew. I feel like he is very good at storytelling, very good at just putting his thoughts into comprehensive videos that get you thinking. When it comes to Sam Kohler, I'm also definitely inspired of his work. Incredible filmmaker. When it comes to the visual side, he's definitely the GOAT. But also when it comes to his mindset, I think he's very advanced, because he's just very good at living in the present moment. At least that's what I see through social media, and that's what I saw through meeting him one time. So definitely an inspiration as well. Besides that, I'm not sure that many other creators. I get a lot of my motivation, to be honest. I just get a lot of my motivation from, I don't know, seeing the change in the world that I want to see. I feel like I also get a lot of motivation from my own journey of when I grew up and all the different things that I experienced through being in the creative industry and paving my way through the world of filmmaking. I feel like that really motivates me to help other people, to make it easier for other people to go that same path and to be able to do something that they really like, you know? So I think I'm really just motivated by making other people be able to follow their passion full time. And whether that be to just make more time on the side of a job you don't like to spend more time on your passion, or in the best way to just monetize your passion and to be able to do just make a living with the things you love, yeah.
And please, show your tattoo.
My tattoo?
Look at this tattoo. He has
Which one?
This one. This one.
No, they have
Look
two.
At that. Passion come first.
Yep.
That's it?
That's the motivation.
That's it, guys. Thank you for all. Thank you, Nick, for coming
Bro,
here.
Bro, thank you so
time.
Much for
yeah.
taking a long time. So we're
video,
recording
though.
Two videos. Yeah. There is like the second one. I don't know which video I post first. But there is a really incredible interview. I need to say thank you so much.
For sure.
Brazil, and to say thank you so much for you. We spent a long time together, and just today, like on the last day,
last
we decided to record in one video.
That was
but
good.
That's
nice.
That was
yeah.
really good.
Awesome.
That's it. Welcome. When you come to Brazil, you'll be like very welcome.
Yeah, we go to Carnival.
Ooh.
Yeah,
he'll be crazy. Imagine. Thank you, you know. Down like aí. Subscribe. How can I say subscribe in German?
Abonnieren.
How can I say it? One time more?
To be honest, I don't even know how the German YouTubers say it, but I would say like in German it's abonnieren. Subscribe below, check out their channel. You're already on their channel. I don't know what I'm talking about. Peace out. Bye bye.